I think it would be great if couples can find the same ideology and work together. But in reality, they often work in different jobs, spending most of their time and energy in their respective workplaces. So, I would like to ask, is it right for an ideal couple to have the same ideology and work together? When we try to work together, we are given a job that we can do together only after we have equipped ourselves to a certain degree. When working together and you don't have sufficient abilities, you are always fighting with your counterpart. If you fight all the time, the work you're doing together will break apart. Working together on a project without agreeing, that project is destined to fail. When you go to work in one place or work in a certain field, you are equipping yourself. If you have equipped yourself correctly and the energy accumulated reaches a certain level, then your conversations need to be on the same page. No matter what kind of work you do in this world, you will always have some things in common. There is always a common ground. There's always common knowledge shared in every work, whether it be a field of saving a man's life to lead a good life, or a field of embalming the diseased body to help the soul to an afterlife. Every work has a commonality 100% of the time, as dicticated by nature's law. If you learn something correctly in one place and learn something else correctly at another place, then you will find something common to do anything together. That is your study. People are in a different environment to equip themselves because they all are in different stages of development. But when it's time to really do something meaningful, it's best to work together. However, in order to work together, each needs to develop themselves to do it together. In Huchan Shide, or post-2012, you will not be treated well no matter how good your skills are. People may use you for your talents, but you will not receive special treatment. It may seem that people are treating you specially, but if you are not equipped enough, you will be fooled by them while they have been taking advantage of you. But this is Huchan Shide, post-2012. An era where you can never live by yourself successfully just because you're talented. Your life is much better when you share it with each other. Therefore, a couple should be able to communicate the meaning of their words with each other. We didn't know the true meaning of husband and wife in Suncheon Shide, the previous era before 2013. It's very important to get this correct right now. They say husband and wife are of one mind and one body, right? When you get married, the pastor says, "Now I pronounce you husband and wife." That's not correct. He should say, "Now you shall make an effort earnestly to become husband and wife." To make it clear, husband and wife don't become one overnight, but through a long-term effort. You two have met each other. Because you two have met, you have to make an effort. Your efforts accumulate to become husband and wife. There are no true husbands and wives yet, as far as I can see. Let me ask you, are you two of one mind and one body? Okay then, you are not husband and wife. Couples need to be united in one mind and body to be husband and wife. The meaning of one mind and one body means understanding each other when they talk. Then who can become husband and wife when two strangers meet? If you suppose the answer or the law is 100, then if it goes over 70%, then it is acknowledged. 70%. If you make an effort, you can definitely reach 70%. Any human being can do it. It is hard to get over the 70%, but you can reach 70%. That is when you will be recognized as one mind and one body. 30% is not enough to say you are of one mind and one body. 50% still is not enough out of 100. If you reach 70%, then you will be recognized as one mind and one body. You will be recognized as husband and wife from heaven. Your hard work has paid off to become a true husband and wife. True husband and wife are different from couples who are not united as one mind and body when they go to the other dimension after death. Non-acknowledged couples cannot roam around holding hands together. Even if you've lived here together for 100 years, you can't hold hands with each other after death. But couples who are united in their efforts are husband and wife even after death. Even after death, the souls remain husband and wife. Your souls will remain together. Even God cannot separate a true husband and wife. It is holy that you have truly become one through hard work. Even God can't separate you. The result of human effort cannot be severed by God. This is the law of nature. Nothing can interfere with your fruits of labor. So husband and wife are made by effort. If you think you've met and become husband and wife, and you think your partner belongs to you just because you're married, then you are preparing for the day when you will break up. A person cannot be yours. It is a relationship you have to put effort into. You become one with a partner when you are living for each other. So do not be greedy. People think greed is a desire for more money, and this is a commonly accepted logic in the world. However, this is not true. Your common knowledge is incorrect. It is only your logic. Then, what is the definition of greed? Trying to control other people's lives to your liking is greed. Every person is a separate independent entity. So, it's greedy to try to control and manipulate other people's lives. This is what you call greed. Do not interfere with other people's lives recklessly. It warrants a divine punishment. Now we have to look at life from a different perspective and not be immersed in the logic of the people who came before us. Logic may be information you can use to help make a correct discernment, but it is not the answer. The answer is an answer when it makes sense to everyone as the law. If there is a logic that we've been following habitually for thousands or even tens of thousands of years, then I am giving you the answer to redefine it. Husband and wife are made by an effort. And family is the same. You become a family through hard work. We think of a family as being blood related. Blood relations are just one of your relationships. The connection we have from the fourth dimension is blood relationships. A relationship by blood is just a relationship, not your family. What type of relationship? It is a relationship to fulfill your duty. When God gives you a child through blood relations, He is giving you a duty to perform. But what is the duty and how to carry it out? You don't know about the duty, so naturally you don't know how to perform your duty. Because we didn't know about the relationship by blood, people say raising children is so hard. Your relationships by blood are relationships that God gives you to do your duty. But family is made by working hard for each other. So when couples meet, are they blood related? No. But they become a family only when they make an effort into the relationship. If they don't, they don't become a family. When you don't try and are greedy to control your partner, arguing with your logic, then it's bound to break. God has given us relationships, but it is up to you to form harmony. God cannot do it for you. We are intellectuals who can properly unravel the laws of grand nature. Only when Hongi Ingans are equipped with new knowledge to reorganize logics of the past and give out the law of grand nature can humanity live in peace. Peace can happen. But if we sit on the sidelines and don't make an effort, we are not doing our part. So humanity will be unhappy. That's the responsibility of the intellectuals and the responsibility of the Hongi Gingan. We will live in great pain after death if we don't do our duty. This is the mission that's given to us. That's why we were taught that we are born on this land with a historical mission to perform, to brighten our ancestors' spirits. We have to make up for everything that our ancestors couldn't accomplish, because we are the last descendant. Each person has a unique talent to master and gather their power internally. It means we should gain sovereign independence. Then use this power to contribute to the prosperity of humanity. When baby boomers were born and entered elementary school as children, they had to learn this message even if it meant physical punishment. If you learn this, then it's because it's your duty. When we were young, we didn't understand the significance of this grand message, but memorized it deep into our bones. But as we became intellectuals and adults, we have to take the message out of our bones and unravel what was implanted into us since childhood. That was the study of Hongi Gingan. It was the message of Hongi Gingan. It was the ideology of Hongi Gingan. Only if you live like that will you become a shining star and be able to get rid of your karma. When you don't do it, and when you don't do what is good for humanity, your karma will not go away even a tiny bit. Just because you have money to spare and give money to people doesn't mean that your karma is going to disappear. But when you deliver your message to humanity and it becomes the cornerstone of world peace, you will have done your job and completed your historical mission. Only then will you have earned enough energy to purify your karma. That's Hongi Gingan. A husband and wife make a very precious relationship. It cannot be done without effort. Do it from now on. From now on, if we know what is right and do what is right, then everything will come true. But there was no one who could tell you the right way until now. Dobans, or truth-seeking colleagues, were meant to study together and discuss what they don't know with each other. Dobans were supposed to study together, but some tried to take over the control and lead other Dobans with their own logic. These people are what you call religious leaders. So far, no leader has emerged, and all of them are Doban. They are intellectuals who studied another field of knowledge in society, just as people in society are intellectuals. These intellectuals should have been Dobans, sharing their knowledge with us. But people who followed them, expecting they could do something special, became fools. We should have become dobans to each other, sharing our knowledge together. That was our mistake. You didn't know. Now we are in an era where all intellectuals become dobans to each other. It's all about convergence and equality. We all have to be in a mutually beneficial relationship in the end. In that sense, a husband and wife are the best dobans to each other. So, do not argue. If you don't know, learn a little. Then all will be solved. I will support you to that end. Do you understand?